The question is, do deficits matter? We often say they do. You'll hear Republicans say they do. And for the last week or two, you've heard from Democrats that they were against cutting taxes because it might add to the deficit. Well, if this is true, tonight we'll get a chance to vote on the deficit. Because you see, Congress, about 6 years ago, put something forward called pay-go budget caps. What does that mean? They kept seeing the deficit explode, so they put these budget caps. And if we would adhere to them, we would actually get the debt under control. But guess what? Congress has evaded them 29 times. So tonight we will have a bill that will be the 30th time that Congress has evaded their own rules on the debt. Is it any surprise that the debt under George W. Bush went from $5 trillion to $10 trillion? Is it any surprise that under President Obama it went from $10 trillion to $20 trillion? Is it any surprise that the debt continues to rise? No, because both parties are responsible for it. Look, I was all for the tax cut. I think it's good for the country. But I'm also for restraining spending. So we did the tax cut earlier in the week. Now we're going to do a spending bill. We have rules in place. The rules in place say that there are budget caps. So they've got a special little waiver they put in the spending bills because we're now going to exceed those caps. So the question is, are we serious about the debt? Are we serious about adding $1 million a minute to the debt? That's what happens. We borrow $1 million a minute. The deficit this year will be over $700 billion, $20 trillion in total. The total debt is bigger than our entire economy. So both sides give lip service to it, and yet both sides want more spending. On the Republican side, this year's request is $80 billion above the caps for military. On the Democrat side, they say, you don't get yours unless we get ours. And yet nobody cares about the debt. So really, the debt's being driven by the GOP wants more military money, but the only way they can get it is giving the Democrats more welfare money. So the interesting thing about this vote is, you've heard the other side of the aisle saying they can't vote for the tax cut because of the debt. If they care about the debt, let's cut spending. This is their chance. This will be a vote on cutting spending. This pay-go budget caps were put in place by the Democrats when they were in the majority in 2010. These are their budget caps. And yet everybody's clamoring to waive them on both sides. We have a real problem in our country, and we must do something about it. Ultimately, there will be a day of reckoning. You cannot continue to borrow so much money. Ultimately, it bankrupts the nation, or the currency becomes worthless, or you get to a point where the interest on the debt actually becomes the number one spending item. Within about a decade, interest will push out all other spending, will be the number one item. We will spend more on interest than national defense. We will spend more on interest than welfare and everything else. And so those who say, well, we have to have more money for military, we got to have more money for welfare, you're going to have none of that if you keep spending money at this rate because we're going to ruin the country through debt. So can we have a strong military? Yes. We spend about $600 billion, but you can't necessarily spend $700 billion. That extra $100 billion is making the debt worse. But it's the same on the other side of the ledger with the Democrats. So we have a chance. There really is a chance. The media would say, oh, you're irresponsible for voting the tax cuts. No, you're irresponsible if you're not also willing to vote for spending cuts. So tonight I will put forward in a few minutes a motion, and this motion will be to say we should obey the spending caps. We put them in place if we truly care. Unless our outrage over debt is fake outrage, if we truly care about the debt, we should vote to keep in place the rules we put in place. These are spending caps. If we care about the next generation, we should vote for the spending caps. So I will put forward a motion that says, let's obey our own rules. But it'll be interesting to watch the vote and see how it turns out. Who truly cares about the debt on either side of the aisle? Who's willing to say, you know what, I'm for tax cuts, but I'm also for saying across the board, we need to have spending restraint. Will we obey our own rules? We have broken our own rules 30 times. This will be the 30th time we broke our own rules on budget caps since 2010. If you go back farther, it's in the hundreds of times. If you were scoring Congress on integrity and honesty toward the own rules that we have set up, it'd be a zero. We aren't adhering to our own rules. So what I'd admonish my colleagues to do is, if you care about debt, vote for this point of order that says we should adhere to our budget caps and we should really, truly care about the budget deficit. Thank you, Mr. President.